young lady who had long golden curls and a pretty little mouth that reminded people of a pink butterfly. She lived in London, and her father was a very fine lawyer.
I think I know this girl. You don't know any such thing. Come on, Lily. Tell us more.
One day, an invitation came to a lovely young lady's house.
Was it to a party? It was to a fancy dress ball, I think.
You are both right, boys, because a fancy dress ball is a party.
Clearly, you see.
A party isn't just a silly birthday party for a child.
John, Michael, stop arguing. Our mother will come in, and that will be the end of the story.
It'll be all John's fault.
Michael, will it will?
Oh, get on with it, Wendy. Did the beautiful young lady go to the ball?
She did, and all the men adored her. She danced every dance, and three men asked to escort her home. One was a judge, one was a member of parliament, and one was a dashing actor who was appearing in a new play.
What did she choose?
She didn't choose any of them.
Then who escorted her home?
Well, the judge, the parliament member, and the actor were all arguing over who was going to escort the beautiful young lady home. A baker named George Don had a handsome carriage over and slipped in beside the beautiful young lady. By the time they had arrived at her house, they'd fallen madly in love.
Did they get married? Of course they did, Sally.
They married and had three lovely children. The oldest thing was named Wendy.
And they named John.
And finally, Michael.
And we mustn't forget about Nana.
Our dear sweet nurse.
Someone's coming.
Nana, are you still awake? And are your charges all sleeping quietly? I thought I heard voices.
Shh!
You mustn't wake the children. They had a very busy day, and they were terribly wound up after dinner. I was afraid they weren't going to sleep at all. And what's this? Do you know this young man? It says, the boy who never grew up. He looks vaguely familiar.
That's because he says he's met you before, Mother.
Isn't he? Are you still awake?
So are we.
Blabbermouth, now I'll have cold porridge for breakfast.
You'll have no such thing. But do tell me what this is.
His name is Peter Pan.
And he lives in Everland, where there are Indians and pirates. And they have the most wonderful battles.
Wendy, what have you been telling your brother? A little imagination goes a long way with young boys.
Oh, I'm not making that, Mother.
Peter stops by every so often.
Have you seen him?
Well, no. But Wendy has.
Haven't you, Wendy? Of course. He flies in every so often just to check on us. Well, actually, he wants us to come play, but I have to tell him no.
But how does this Peter Pan get in?
He flies in the window.
Oh, I see. We haven't been told about an intruder.
I didn't think you'd believe me.
Oh, dear. A few too many sweets tonight, I'm afraid.
But he's real, isn't he, Wendy?
Oh, he's as real as any of us.
And sometimes I'm going to go off the battle with him. Don't forget me. I can wield a bigger sword than you.
You'll have to leave battles till morning. Right now, snuggle under the covers and close your eyes. That's right. Close your eyes, my babies, and sleep. And Peter Pan, the boy who never grew up, I hope you're safely tucked in when your mother can keep her eye on you.
Whatever is that?
That's not whatever, it's a who!
How did you get up here?
I flew, of course, wouldn't you? I mean, you're three stories up.
Oh dear, I must have had too many sweets.
Tink's able to sit down. You look a bit pale.
And who is Tink?
Tinkerbell, my faithful little companion. And I like you too, Tink.
Just what is it you want, young man?
I'm no man, not or. I'm a boy, just a boy. See, I got all my first teeth, and I shall be a boy forever and ever.
The boy who never grew up.
Tink, no!
Why, if I'm lucky.
I have to finish in the kitchen, so you're in charge, Nana.
And just one of those. you're watching for pirates, Ron.
Well, that's all well and good, but if they're hiding, they sure know we're here now.
Oh, I wish Peter would get back. Where could he have gone to?
He'll be back. He said he had important business to attend to.
But what if the pirates attack? We'll fight them to the death, right?
Till our last breath.
I'll take three at a time.
No one can live after being hit with this.
Oh, no. What was that?
Pirates!
Was close.
They're itching for a fight. I hope they didn't hear my teeth chattering.
My knee's knocking.
Oh gosh, we're safe now.
They've gone the long way around the island.
We can sit back and relax.
Wait, why are we running? We're Indians!
Yeah!
sick when Peter is here.
Well, he's not, so there.
There what?
Just so there.
Look there!
It's Tinkerbell. Where's Peter T?
He's being chased by a huge bird.
You're to shoot down the bird, Toodles.
But Peter doesn't like to shoot down anything.
Well, he says you better do it.
Well, Peter will be very, very angry.
Hey, look! There's the bird. That doesn't look like a bird.
Well, that looks like
a lady!
Come on, let's go see what it is.
Tink told me to shoot.
She said it was a bird.
She's the most prettiest bird I've ever seen.
I wonder where she's from.
Someplace wonderful.
Greetings, boys. I bet.
Why are you cheering?
Hooray.
Greetings. I'm Becky Miller for you all. Haven't you seen her? She was flying this way. We saw her, Peter.
And Tink said, she said.
I was to shoot. So, I did.
Tink, where are you? What's the meaning of this? This isn't funny, Tink. You know Toodles is the best with bow and arrow. Now look at Wendy. Wake her up this instant. Now, Tink!
Oh, Wendy, we thought you were a goner.
What happened? He shot you down.
I'm very, very sorry, ma'am.
Well, I should think I'm none the worse for wear. No, nothing broken or bruised. Are you really going to be our mother?
Well, I'm not sure.
Can you make a cake?
Of course you can. Chocolate, four layers tall.
Can you tell us stories?
The most wonderful stories of faraway places.
Can you soak the holes in my stockings?
I brought my sewing kit.
Can you?
Yes.
Tuck us in at night?
I would love to.
Yeah!
Woo!
I guess that means I am your mother.
And we'll show you our cave.
You live in a cave? Really? Safest place from the pirates in Indians.
No, I should know. They're really pirates in Indians.
They fought to the death right here. Not 10 minutes ago.
Coming here.
I'll be alone with you. I wouldn't want to miss one of your swords.
Will I get a sword?
Only the tallest gets swords.
What about me?
How about a dagger?
Nice and sharp.
I sure like that very, very much.
Tinkerbell? That wasn't a very nice thing to do. Wendy is too a very nice girl. Of course, I don't like her more than I like you. Unless you do something like that again. Do you hear me, Tink? I like her all. If you do something like that again, and don't sit there pouting, or I'm your baby.
Well, now they've found the mother. What's Hook going to say about that?
Alright then, for today's lesson.
I thought you said we were going to have a picnic.
That's why you said we were coming to the lagoon. I have the picnic right here.
Good. I'm ever so hungry.
Did you make sandwiches like last night and the night before that?
They were so delicious.
My stomach is growling so much I can't hear myself think.
But we must finish your lessons before we have fun.
I don't think I like lessons.
Don't be silly, John. You've always loved school.
Have we gone to school?
Of course, a real school, with desks and rows and a proper blackboard, with a teacher who carried a ruler.
Funny, I can't remember.
I can't imagine how you can be so forgetful. All right then, everyone. Question one. What color were your mother's eyes?
What if we don't remember?
Well, just put a check mark. Question two. Which is taller, father or mother? What song do mothers sing at bedtime? What did father always say when he couldn't tie his tie? All right then, let me see what we've got. Why, they're all check marks. And you too. Oh, John, you haven't answered one question.
I can't remember. Can you please have something to eat?
I'm starving.
All right.
Hey, that's not fair. I should be the one carrying the basket.
And why should you?
Because Wendy's my... Well, she's something to me.
You're just saying that, John.
You're a lost boy, just like the rest of us.
Aren't you hungry, Peter?
How do you make me find Mother Wendy? All
and tired.
You want me to drown?
Well, that's Cat Cook's idea, my dear. Not ours.
You can let me go if you want. My father will be most grateful.
He will he?
Yes, he'll give you anything you ask for.
That's so.
Well, that's a very tempting offer, my dear. But I'm afraid if we let you go, Cat Cook won't like us anymore. And if Cat can't like us anymore, he has down to us on this. Might stop the plane.
Aye, it's just as he says.
Peter, we must save Tiger Lily.
Ahoy there, you lovers!
Captain, is that you?
Sparky?
Aye, aye, Captain.
What are you two doing?
We're tying the princess to the rock like you ordered, sir.
Set her free.
Free?
Cut those ropes and let her go.
But, Captain!
At once, do you hear? Or I'll politely be talking to you.
Better run off, ma'am. Sorry, guys.
Peter, control yourself.
Don't impersonate that fool look beautifully. I was saving that person for such an occasion as this.
Now, Peter, it's time to go home and take your medicine. You're looking very well today, Captain.
Where's the princess? The tide's about to come in.
You told us to let her go, sir.
You fools! You ingrates! You landlubbers! Well, now, he sighs.
He sighs again.
Captain, what's up?
The game's up, haven't you noticed? The boys' hair is combed, there are no more holes in their socks. They say, yes, ma'am, and no, thank you.
What could it mean?
They found a mother.
What's a mother?
Oh, you don't want to know. It's a lovely creature that melts your heart to doing just what she wants you to do.
What does she want you to do?
Oh, study your lessons, clean your room, eat your peas, and worst of all, be polite!
Well, now that's terrible!
There'll be no more fun in Neverland. No more fights because they'll get their pants dirty. No more yelling because they'll wake the baby birds. No more fun because Mother says so.
Well, what, Captain? You can't let that happen.
Well, what can I do?
Well, I'm sure someone of your cruel, rotten disposition thinks something diabolical.
Oh, Smee, stop flattering me. Even if you are right.
Captain?
Don't bother me, Starkey. I'm thinking.
Well, now, it appears the tide.
Hush! A genius is at work.
Oh, but Captain, don't drown.
I've got it. All we have to do is get rid of the mother. Then we can be rid of Peter Pan and have the island all to ourselves. Aha! Well, I'll congratulate myself, even if you two don't.
Well, now, we'll get the boats to rescue you, sir.
Boat? Rescue me? What for? Why didn't you warn me? You fools! You ingrates! You landlubbers! Get the boat! Get the boat! Oh, no! Oh, no, not him! Shoot you! Get away! Get back! I don't want him to taste me! I'm tough and stringy! All skin and bones! No meat at all! And I taste terrible! Come on!
Thank you.
I can't really be dead.
Look at that. Toodles is a big baby.
He's trying. It's okay. It'll turn out all right.
Shh.
Don't
spoil it.
Come on, Wendy.
Yes. Up with Prince Gister, she wakes up and they ride off into the sunset together. Happy, super,
fun. Aw, Pan, you spoiled the ending.
Is that what happens?
I hope so. I don't want Snow White to stay dead forever.
That's exactly what happens. She must have heard the story before, Pan.
We don't have a mother.
Except the bee lady.
Since Pan's ruined the ending, tell us another one, Wendy.
What about an adventure instead? You haven't had a good fight in over an hour. I'm sure that you're itching for some swordplay.
No, Peter. Another story, Wendy. Please, we like your stories ever so much.
I don't know, Chief. We're all going a little bit lazy, I think. I know you'll come, but it's more fun with everyone.
I'm so tired.
The fish pie for lunch is so good, I still can't move.
You're such a good cook, Wendy.
You'll stay with us always, won't you?
That's a very long time, Liz.
But it seems like you've been here forever.
I'll tell you one more story before you must go out to play. Does that suit you, Peter?
As long as it is a short one.
Very well. There once was a gentleman.
I'd rather he'd be a little boy.
Or a white rat. Quiet. And there was a lady.
But she's not dead, is she?
No, of course she's alive. Very much so. Now, the gentleman's name was Mr. Darling, and the lady's name was Mrs. Darling.
I think I knew them.
They were married, you know, to each other. And what do you think they had?
White rats!
No, of course not. They had three descendants.
Children, of course. So they had three children?
And a very faithful nurse, Nana.
So far, it's a wonderful story, Wendy.
It is, isn't it? And they lived in a large house that had a splendid nursery that had a large window that opened at night so moonlight could come in.
Are they there now?
Oh, no. They flew away one night.
That's silly. Children can't fly.
But they did. They landed on a wonderful island and had many adventures. There were pirates and Indians and all sorts of creatures in the forest. But one day, the children began to miss their mother and father.
Do I have a mother and father?
Of course not. That's why you're a lost boy.
What happened to the children, Wendy?
They decided they wanted to fly back to their nursery.
But what if the window was closed, Mom?
That would be awful!
They wouldn't be able to get in! But the girl, who is the oldest, knew that her mother would always leave the window open. Because she knew in her heart that they would be coming back.
That was a splendid story.
I wonder if there's a window open waiting for me.
Stuff and nonsense! What is it, Peter? You look terribly ill.
You're right about mothers, Wendy. Like you, I thought my mother had the window open for me. So I flew away instead of
many moons and moons and moons.
But when I flew back, the window was closed and locked. And there was another kid sleeping in my bed.
Are you sure mothers are like that?
Cross my heart and hope to die.
Wendy, I want to go home.
Me too.
Yes, we will.
Can't leave tonight.
We'll leave at once. Mother and father are probably sure we're never coming back by now. Peter, will you make the necessary arrangements?
If you wish. What are you talking about, T? Oh, stop it.
But you can't go, Wendy.
It would be so much worse than before you came.
Because now we know what it's like to have a mother.
Please don't leave us.
Who will tell the story?
Who will cook us fish pies?
I have an idea. Quick!
We have to wash our hands and faces before we leave.
Are you sure the window will be open?
Then we have to wash our hands and ears.
I think that's a very good idea, Toodles.
So what's Peter going to
say? Oh, be quiet, Tink. It's none of your business.
Just because you hate Wendy doesn't mean we all have.
She's the only mother we've ever had.
There now, you both look splendid.
3, 2, 1.
Hey, what's going on here?
Let's go, dear. I'm afraid it's quite a problem.
Let me go. What's going on here, men?
We aren't going to love Wendy, please.
Wait, miss, our story is too much.
And our socks would never get mended.
And we never have another fish pot.
But I can't stay tied up. I want to be able to mend your socks or make another fish pie this way.
I have an idea. Let's take them with us. That would be great fun.
You're right, John. I'm sure we can find a mother and father to adopt you all.
Our very own mother and father?
say, you boys?
Yeah!
Oh, all right. Go there and fight with mother and father. But don't come crawling back to me when you want an adventure or two. Now, Peter, before you leave, I want you to take your medicine. I'll leave you as you say. You're not my mother.
Very well. I'll leave it over to you. Say goodbye, boys.
Trap.
Now, who would set trap?
Peter wouldn't dare.
But he didn't want us to leave.
What about Hook?
This could be dangerous.
Have Wendy and Lockwood stay here while we go on to investigate.
That's a good idea, Great Big Little Panther.
We'll take this detour cautiously. Be ready to fight.
We want to come and fight, too.
I've got another sword for my hand.
You'll do no such thing. If we're going to find you a mother and father, you've got to be clean and presentable when we arrive.
We'll guard Wendy while you're gone.
Nothing can happen to us. Come, we go see what's up.
Why, Michael Stebbins, darling, your sock is unraveling. Soon you won't have any luck on your foot.
Can you sew it up?
For now, we'll just stop it from unraveling. There.
Gee, now we gotta sit and wait for hours.
I'm bored already.
And I'm hungry all of a sudden. Children, I'm afraid when we go home, we'll have to practice some manners. Maybe this would be a very good time to start.
What are manners? Things like don't slurp your soup.
And don't wipe your mouth on your sleeve.
And never blow your nose in public.
And don't laugh with your mouth full of milk.
Sounds like a lesson, don't do this.
And don't do that.
Well, you don't want to act like monkeys in front of people, do you?
And what's wrong with monkeys?
Nothing, a bath and a shave and a proper education. Plenty here. Now, when you meet someone, you are to bow and say, how do you do? I'm pleased to meet you.
How do you do? I'm pleased to meet you.
Let's try that with a bow now, from the waist. How do you do? I'm pleased to meet you.
How do you do? I'm pleased to meet you.
Once again, please, and bow this time as you did before. How do you do? I'm pleased to meet you.
How do you do? I'm pleased to meet you.
Turn and say it again. How do you do? I'm pleased to meet you. I didn't hear you. Oh dear, I'm afraid you're not pleased to meet any of you. How do you do? You certainly look dashing today, Captain Hook.
But you're the one who appears to be dashing.
Yes, I'm sorry. We can't stay. But we're on our way home, so we won't be bothering you any longer. Come on, boys.
Actually, I don't think you're going anywhere but to our ship. Am I right, men?
That seems to be the plan, aye, Captain?
And just what do you intend to do with us?
Oh, wouldn't you like to know?
There's that nasty firefly again.
That's no firefly. It's Peter Pan's friend.
And where is Pan?
We'll never tell you.
Take him, men. Put him in shackles.
And where will you be, Captain?
Getting rid of Peter Pan. Once and for all.
Peter, watch out, Peter.
Yo-ho, yo-ho, the pirate's life, the flag is cold and bones. A merry hour, hemp and rope, and hey for Davy Jones.
You guys are so bad.
the epitome of self-confidence. Conceit! Pure, overwhelming conceit!
No, I feel no compassion.
I feel I might just put him out of my misery.
But how?
I could just run him through with my hook. But that's a bit messy. Anthony just washed this shirt. He wouldn't appreciate it covered with blood. Even Peter Pan's blood. I could just smother him with his pillow. But that would take some energy. And I'm conserving my energy for the glorious welcoming of a mother to our ship. I could just set this place ablaze. But there really isn't much for a flame to catch. Wait a second. Poison. Get out of here, you nasty firefly! It's gone! Now, do I dump it down his open mouth while he slumbers? That's not very sportsmanlike of me. I need a more subtle means of delivery. Something that can't be traced back to me. Now, what one of these is he more likely to drink? For Peter Pan, to be taken whenever Wendy says so. Ha! So, our new mother will be Peter's own angel of death. Drops in there, and Peter Pan will breathe no more. Oh, this is so much easier than I thought. It's almost too delicious for words. My heart is bursting with good cheer. It's a great day to be a pirate. It's a great day to be anybody but Peter Pan.
My dear,
because we're heading home.
Ah!
Get moving, you two. Find out what happened to your mates.
I don't really care, sir.
I have a key to the car.
Get in there before I make you walk the plank.
No, no, no!
Who's in there? I'm coming in myself, and you better be prepared to be skewered like the chicken you are. Here I come. One, two, three.
Why did you depart to Captain Hook?
Pam, how can it be you?
Jake saved my life.
Maybe once, but not the second time.
Do be careful, Peter.
We knew you were one, Peter.
We never doubted you for a second. You're just like a cat.
You've got 10 lives.
Which you'll need.
No, Peter!
Come on! Peter, fly, fly!
Rise 1 inch, Pam, and you're a dead fishy. You've had your fun, boy, and taken years off my life. So now, I'm going to add them all back on.
Fly, Peter, fly!
I'll take this rat down a fair fight!
Eliza, was it your fault? It must have been a cat.
my fault. And I'll never, ever forgive myself.
Oh, my God, how could you ask?
I didn't think anything was going to happen.
Okay.